Siddharth Purohit of Angel is joining in. Siddharth, what's your call on this IPO? Would you recommend a subscribe?
Yeah, morning. In fact, we have a subscribe rating on the issue, and there are a couple of points what we like about the issue is that, you know, the organization has a fairly decent amount of, you know, experience. It has been present for almost two decades now. Now, if you look at the loan book, it is largely secured in nature and has been financing towards asset which has the potential to generate revenues. So that de-risk its portfolio. Now, if you look at their growth, last 4 years, growth on the AUM has been fairly strong at 30% CAGR, and that is, I think, much above the industry growth rate. Now, if you look at their asset quality, despite this kind of an aggressive growth, the management has been able to fairly contain their asset quality at a strong level. The GNP of 1.6%, net NP of 1% is fairly, I think, strong, given the condition that is like, you know, prevailing in the credit scenario at the market right now. Now, if you look at the potential, what I believe is that, you know, given the current capital adequacy, I believe that the company has fairly strong potential to deliver similar kind of growth in the coming 3-4 years. And looking at the management's like, you know, commentary, even I feel that, you know, they're well prepared to migrate to the small finance bank. And despite all the challenges of meeting this SLR CRR ratio, they'll be in a position to possibly deliver double digit return on equity for next 2-3 years time. So all the like, you know, parameters are, I think, justifying the valuations that, you know, this issue is quoting.
Okay, so Siddharth, I take your point, Siddharth, but you know what, let me just put in a point here. You know, you have Ujjivan and Equitas last year, great plays, but we've seen a significant correction, for example, in Ujjivan, and you know, at the price at which you know this particular issue is coming, it will have a higher market cap than Ujjivan and you know Equitas put together. And even in terms of price to book value, I think it's almost double of what San Ujjivan is trading at. So what would justify that?
See, what I believe, certainly, like, you know, Ujjivan Equitas also had a very good start, but their reliance on the microfinance, like, you know, industry is much higher than any other NBFC. And just to compare, AU doesn't have, like, you know, microfinance as such, like, you know, which is very unsecured in nature and which can be cyclical. Now, we have seen in the last two quarters, because of a lot of factors, whether it is, like, you know, political environment or maybe, you know, some, like, you know, agri, like, you know, stress on the agri sector. So microfinance as a business has like, you know, been volatile in terms of nature, and we have seen that, you know, the results has not been really great for microfinance company for the last two quarters. So what differentiates, I believe, you compared to other NBFCs or the small finance bank is their like, you know, ability to grow without compromising on asset quality and backed by like, you know, secured lending. So their asset quality will not get compromised too much because of the secured nature of lending. Now, there might be competition because even other small finance bank also are trying to get into those space in an aggressive way. But I feel that, you know, AU will have an early mover advantage in, you know, scaling up because they already have a history of, you know, financing vehicle, which forms almost 50% of the portfolio, unlike some other small finance bank where almost 50% would be to your microfinance, which is fairly volatile. So I think,
Sure.
That's why I believe that valuations are justified.
Okay, I take your point that you have a subscribe on the issue. Thanks a lot for joining us. That's the Angel View.